Hello everyone, my name is Ever Barbero, and today I'd like to talk about example 5.2 in my textbook, Finite Element Analysis of Composite Materials Using Abaqus. In chapter 5, we explore 3D solid modeling of laminated composites. In this example, we calculate the interlaminar stresses sigma z and sigma yz. These cannot be calculated by lamination theory or by shell elements. In module part, we use modeling space, 3D, base feature, solid, type, extrusion. With the sketcher, we draw the bottom of the strip, in the XY plane. Then, we extrude the half thickness above the middle surface from Z equals 0 to Z equals 2.5. Above the middle surface means Z positive, in the direction of the blue arrow in the triad on the bottom left corner. Now we partition the solid into two laminas. Create a datum plane, offset by Z equals 1.25 from the XY plane, to position the 0-90 interface. Then, partition the cell, using the datum plane. In module assembly, create an independent instance if the part. In module property, enter the material properties of the lamina, using engineering constants. Note that E3 equals E2, Nu13 equals Nu12, G13 equals G12, and G23 is calculated from E2 and Nu23. Next, we use the section manager to create a solid, homogeneous section with material 1. Now we assign that section 1 to both laminas, so that both have the same material properties. Now we assign different material orientations to the laminas. Rotated 90 degrees for the lamina touching the middle surface. And 0 for the top lamina. Notice that the grayed out value, 90, is not used, because additional rotation is, none. Now we use the left tree, to double check the orientations are okay. For the 90 lamina, the blue arrows point along Y, yellow along minus X, red along Z. For the 0 lamina, the blue arrows point along X, yellow along Y, red along Z. As usual, we need a step. In module load, rather than a load, we apply an axial displacement, that produces the strain epsilon x, that we want to apply. Symmetry with respect to the YZ plane. Symmetry with respect to the XZ plane. Symmetry with respect to the XY plane. Now we mesh, with single bias, so that the mesh is refined towards the top edge of the laminate. On the edge itself, we want double bias, so that the mesh is refined towards the middle of the plate, far away from both, the loaded end at x equals L, and the fixed end at x equals 0. Now select the shorter edges, still unseated. Element type, quadratic. As usual, we need a job, then submit it, and when completed, it results. For results, we can look at displacement U1, which is along the x direction. By default, CAE displays strain and stresses in lamina, also called local, or material, coordinate system, 1, 2, 3, not global, x, y, z. If we want stress and strain tensors in global coordinates, x, y, z, we have to apply a transformation to the results. We transform to the coordinate system of lamina number 2, the zero lamina, which is already aligned with the global coordinates. You can see that now, E11 is uniform everywhere, and equal to the applied strain. In fact, E11 is actually the global strain EXX, but you have to know that from context. plot S33, like this, along the width of the specimen, slightly below the 090 interface, we have to create a path in the model. Like this. We choose to define the path by a list of points. Like this. Starting at x equals 20, y equals 0, z equals 1.24, slightly below the 090 interface, end up at x equals 20, y equals 2, z equals 1.24. Now we take the data along the path, and we save it on an XY data object. And now we plot, like this. And now we save the data. Since the XY data is internal, not easily accessible, we want to save it to a text file, called a report, or RPT file, like this. And here it is. The RPT file, with two columns, values of X, from the center line of the specimen to the edge, 0 to 10 millimeters, and values of sigma 33, almost 0 at the center line and shooting up near the edge. The maximum value does not mean anything because you can make it as high as you want by further refining the mesh. That means that a failure criterion based on strength is not appropriate. You have to read the textbook to understand this. Okay, that's it for today. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe. You can find more details in the textbook by following the link in the description. Thank you.